In recent years, resilience has become an important concept for both scholars and practitioners working on disaster response, preparedness, and international development. One approach to understanding a system's resilience is to assess the strength and dynamism of a network of organizations comprising that system. Networks can represent relationships within a community and describe how well new ideas, information, and resources can flow through it. Interactions between organizations and communities determine the network structure, as well as the strength and depth of relationships between actors. With respect to disaster preparedness, network actors are typically humanitarian and development organizations working with local communities to provide information, training, and investment to prepare for and respond to future disasters. A new report by HHI's Program on Resilient Communities provides a picture of which actors are connected around disaster risk reduction in the Philippines, how they are connected, how often they connect, and characteristics of those connections. Understanding and mapping these connections provides information useful in both finding a system's strengths and identifying gaps in services and coverage. Researchers recruited and surveyed organizations of all types, levels, and scales, from local government units and social service organizations to national government agencies and international non-government organizations, or INGOs. This enabled researchers to capture a snapshot of relationships between over 500 actors in the disaster preparedness and resilience sector. Through analyzing those relationships, the Program on Resilient Communities made a couple key findings. First, despite concerted and largely successful efforts to develop local capacity among national NGOs and government entities, international organizations continue to play an important role among the network of disaster management actors in the Philippines. Findings suggest INGOs act as a primary means to connect local organizations with the larger disaster preparedness and resilience system. While INGO involvement has clear benefits, local agents' reliance on INGOs for collaboration and funding opportunities can impede resilience and sustainability of the entire system. For instance, only 18% of actors identified in the network were international organizations. If these actors were to withdraw their support, researchers found the network would lose 39% of its connections, directly impacting local actors' ability to maintain coordination and collaboration. Researchers also found a lack of reciprocal collaboration between actors. Less than 1% of relationships were reciprocal. Most actors seek information or support rather than cross-collaborating and working jointly on initiatives. In addition, actors often indicated they seek help from larger or higher-level organizations. For example, local NGOs tend to go to national or international NGOs. Community-based or people's organizations tend to go to national NGOs. Fostering more bidirectional relationships would help to improve the flow of information, resources, and ideas to more actors in the system and help organizations better coordinate on specific issue areas. Better serving communities that bear the greatest disaster-related risk requires developing a rich understanding of those factors that best contribute to their resilience or impede their ability to prepare for future disasters. Network analyses can be an important tool in this task, and HHI's findings suggest academic institutions, government, and non-government organizations working in the Philippines should consider how to foster deeper and more collaborative relationships to achieve greater stability and sustainability in the face of a changing climate and subsequent disasters.